On Wednesday, Ukraine's Air Force chief reported that Russia had launched 13 Shahed drones overnight, with 10 being successfully intercepted and downed in the Kharkiv, Sumy and Kyiv regions. Mykola Oleshchuk stated that various defense mechanisms, including anti-aircraft missile units and electronic warfare equipment, were deployed to repel the air attack. Simultaneously, Ukraine's Navy declared that it had either sunk or incapacitated a third of all Russian warships in the Black Sea during the span of over 2 years of conflict. Dmytro Pletenchuk disclosed that the recent strike on Saturday targeted the Russian amphibious landing ship Kostyantin Olshansky, which was docked in Sevastopol in Russia-occupied Crimea. The ship, previously Ukrainian, had been seized by Russia in 2014. Pletenchuk revealed that two other landing ships of the same type, Azov and Yamal, along with the intelligence ship Ivan Kurs, were also damaged in the attack. Utilizing Neptune missiles built by Ukraine, the weekend assault additionally targeted Sevastopol's port facilities and an oil depot. Pletenchuk asserted that the ultimate objective was the removal of all military vessels associated with the Russian Federation from the Azov and Black Sea regions. In a separate development, Ukraine's President Volodymyr Zelensky replaced Oleksiy Danilov, the Secretary of Ukraine's National Security Council, with Oleksandr Litvinenko, the head of the Foreign Intelligence Service. Zelensky announced that Danilov would be reassigned to new responsibilities, with further details to be disclosed later, emphasizing the country's ongoing efforts to reinforce and rejuvenate its state apparatus across all sectors. Furthermore, Ukraine launched additional airstrikes on Belgorod, situated just over the border inside Russia. Regional Governor Vyacheslav Gladkov reported ground damage and stated that air defenses had engaged 18 incoming targets.
Subscribe to One India channel and never miss an update.